안녕하세요. 안차키입니다. Thanks for joining us on Let's Speak Korean. And with us as usual is 지승현 선생님. 안녕하세요.
안녕하세요. 안녕하세요. 지승현입니다. It's good to see you again.
Now, in our last lesson, we learned how to form the future tense with verbs. Let's get a quick review. 선생님, 주말에 뭐 할 거예요?
주말에 친구를 만날 거예요.
Sounds like fun. Okay, well, this time we're going to learn how to form commands that we can use to ask someone for something or for someone to do something. Now, let's take a look at the clip.
마이클 씨, 여기 앉으세요. 이 커피 드세요.
고맙습니다.
마이클 씨, 내일 저녁에 바빠요?
아니요, 안 바빠요.
그럼 내일 우리 집에 오세요.
왜요?
내일 파티가 있어요. 친구들이 많이 올 거예요.
그래요? 한국 사람들이 많이 와요?
네, 많이 와요.
민욱 씨도 올 거예요?
네, 올 거예요.
친구들이 몇 시에 와요?
6시에 올 거예요.
네, 알았어요.
내일 저녁에 꼭 오세요.
All right, we saw Suji asking Michael if he is busy for dinner tomorrow. And she asked him to come over to her house. Michael asked why, and it seems that there's a party at Suji's house. And lots of friends are coming, including Minook. Now, Suji invites Michael and tells him to be sure to come. So let's then get a check of what's in this lesson. We're going to learn how to form commands to request someone to do something. The way to do it is to add either 세요 or 으세요 to the end of the verb stem, and you'll have a command. Before we go on, let's study some vocabulary that we'll need to learn the expressions.
기다리다 기다리다 앉다 앉다
마이클 씨, 여기 앉으세요. 이 커피 드세요.
고맙습니다.
마이클 씨, 내일 저녁에 바빠요?
아니요, 안 바빠요.
그럼 내일 우리 집에 오세요.
Now, Suji is using quite a number of commands here. Now, the sentences were such as, sit here, drink your coffee, and come to my house. Now, Michael, sit here. How would we say this in Korean?
마이클 씨, 여기 앉으세요.
Drink your coffee in Korean.
이 커피 드세요.
So all you have to do is add either 으세요 or 세요 to the verb stem to make the command. Now let's try some other expressions. Wait in the library. How would we say this in Korean?
도서관에서 기다리세요.
Read a Korean book. Now what is this expression in Korean?
한국어 책을 읽으세요.
So we add either 세요 or 으세요. Now, 선생님, could you tell us about the difference between the two?
Sure. Mm-hmm. It's really same rule that has come up many times before. If the verb stem ends in either the character 를 or a vowel, then follow it with 세요. If it ends with a consonant, we add 으세요. It's simple, right?
I see. So all we have to do is add either 세요 or 으세요 to the verb stem. Now, I think it's time to try our hand at forming some other commands for some verbs. Now, please listen carefully to 선생님.
기다리세요. 기다리세요. 앉으세요. 앉으세요.
그래요? 한국 사람들이 많이 와요?
네, 많이 와요.
친구들이 몇 시에 와요?
6시에 올 거예요.
Now let's learn how to ask the question by adding either 아요 or 어요 to the verb stem. Now I'm going to ask 선생님 where she's waiting. How should I do this?
어디에서 기다려요?
To this question, we can answer by saying, for instance, wait in the library. How would we say this?
도서관에서 기다려요.
We came across the expression 기다리세요 before, and this time it's simply 기다려요. They both mean the same thing. Now remember, I've mentioned this before, but in spoken Korean, we often leave out the subject particle. It doesn't really matter. Okay, the person asking the question in the example that we saw before asked where he should wait, and the answer was that he should wait in the library. Now let's practice with another example. 선생님, where should I sit? 선생님, 어디에 앉아요?
이 의자에 앉아요.
Let's repeat after 선생님 one more time.
이 의자에 앉으세요. 이 의자에 앉으세요. 이 의자에 앉아요. 이 의자에 앉아요.
Now for a practice of all the expressions that we've learned so far. Now I trust that you're all following along. Okay? 어디에서 기다려요?
도서관에서 기다리세요.
여기에 앉아요?
네, 여기에 앉으세요.
Now, let's check up some new words in this lesson. Now, Suji says the following expression when she hands Michael his coffee. She says, 이 커피 드세요. Okay, this is to tell the person to take the food or the drink. Now, if the word for to eat is 먹다, why didn't she say 먹으세요 and instead said 드세요? Now, could you tell us about the difference?
Sure. 드세요 is the one of the honorific form we have in Korean. We use honorific form when we have to be polite to the person we are talking to. And in Korean, we have a lot of words that has the same meaning, but their honorific forms are totally different. They look different and they sound different. So the honorific form of 먹다 is 들다. So when you're talking to the person, we say 드세요.
Shall we get some more practice?
드세요. 드세요.
Now for a wrap-up of the lesson, let's go over the expressions one by one along with the skit.
Michael 씨, 여기 앉으세요.
마이클 씨, 여기 앉으세요.
이 커피 드세요.
이 커피 드세요.
고맙습니다.
고맙습니다.
마이클 씨, 내일 저녁에 바빠요?
마이클 씨, 내일 저녁에 바빠요?
아니요, 안 바빠요.
아니요, 안 바빠요.
그럼 내일 우리 집에 오세요.
그럼 내일 우리 집에 오세요.
왜요?
왜요?
내일 파티가 있어요. 친구들이 많이 올 거예요.
"내일 파티가 있어요. 친구들이 많이 올 거예요."
그래요? 한국 사람들이 많이 와요?
그래요? 한국 사람들이 많이 와요?
네, 많이 와요.
네, 많이 와요.
민욱 씨도 올 거예요?
민욱 씨도 올 거예요?
네, 올 거예요.
네, 올 거예요.
친구들이 몇 시에 와요?
친구들이 몇 시에 와요?
6시에 올 거예요.
6시에 올 거예요.
내일 저녁에 꼭 오세요.
내일 저녁에 꼭 오세요.
Good practice, right? Okay, we have the entire clip for you once again, so try to memorize the expressions and the situations they are used in.
마이클 씨, 여기 앉으세요. 이 커피 드세요.
고맙습니다.
마이클 씨, 내일 저녁에 바빠요?
아니요, 안 바빠요.
그럼 내일 우리 집에 오세요.
왜요?
내일 파티가 있어요. 친구들이 많이 올 거예요.
그래요? 한국 사람들이 많이 와요?
네, 많이 와요.
민욱 씨도 올 거예요?
네, 올 거예요.
친구들이 몇 시에 와요?
6시에 올 거예요.
네, 알았어요.
내일 저녁에 꼭 오세요.
following up on our previous lesson, we're going to learn more about 받침. Now this time it is the character 티귿. We're going to find out how it functions when it is added to a letter. Let's add the character 티귿 to the letter A. We'll try pronouncing it.
앗 앗 앗
Now for some words that contain 티귿 as the 받침. Now please follow along and try to memorize them.
듣다 듣다 걷다 걷다 숟가락 숟가락
Well, it's time to say goodbye for this edition of Let's Speak Korean. Now, in this lesson, we learned how to convert verbs into their command forms. A quick review now.
선생님, 내일 우리 집에 오세요.
왜요?
생일이에요.
그래요? Happy birthday.
Thank you. Well, I hope you're not really going to come. That was just an example. Okay, let's stop here for now. And until next time, 안녕히 계세요.